Greetings, and welcome to the Bureau of Local Assessment's presentation of How to Use the New Growth Excel Template.
Beginning in fiscal 22, the Bureau of Local Assessment is requiring that all communities use the same standardized spreadsheet as supporting documentation to their new growth submission. The New Growth Excel Template is to be uploaded to the current document section of the LA 13 in Gateway if reporting new growth. Please refer to the instruction sheet for detailed information and directions for formatting specifications. The Bureau of Local Assessment would encourage assessors to work with their CAMA system vendors to ensure they have the necessary and updated programming and reporting tools they need to track and extract new growth for completing the template. The new growth template and instruction sheet can be found in two locations. The first is Gateway. By selecting the tax rate tab, you will find both the template and instructions on the landing page. The second is on the Division of Local Services website. The direct link to the Division of Local Services website can be seen below. There are various methods to enter data into the template. Let's review them. The first is to manually data enter each row directly into the template. Data can be entered concurrently as updates from map changes, forms of lists, and inspections are entered into your CAMA system. The template itself acts as a method of tracking growth. Data is automatically entered in the correct format. Be sure to proof and check your entries. Another method would be to extract the necessary growth reports out of your CAMA system, reformat as necessary, and then copy and paste into the new growth template. This method allows users to flag and track growth within their CAMA systems. Reports can then be extracted using filters for growth flags, inspection dates, permits, etc. When using this method, your spreadsheet must be edited and formatted before you can copy and paste into the new growth template. Be sure to proof and check your entries. Lastly, assessors have the option to maintain their normal new growth spreadsheet and then copy and paste into the template. This method allows assessors to track growth in their usual format. The data must be edited and formatted before you can copy and paste into the new growth template. Be sure to proof and check your entries. Should you decide to maintain your old new growth spreadsheet and copy and paste into the standardized new growth template, one of the most important things to know is the manner in which column F, the class column, should be formatted. Much like the LA3, the new growth template is looking for an overall 3-digit class code. This class code column, column F, must be formatted as a text column. It is important to remember that the class code entered must be the overall class for the parcel. Directions for formatting column F can be found on the template itself, below the totals table, as well as within the accompanying instruction sheet. Shown here are two examples where column F was not formatted correctly, which will result in the total new growth to be either missed entirely or calculated incorrectly. Below is an example of correct formatting, illustrated by the green triangle present in the top left corner of each cell in column F. This signifies that formatting is present. Column G is optional, but can be useful to communities that track through and extract from their CAMA systems. Any flag or code used in your CAMA system to describe growth can be manually entered as well. Column H describes the reason for new growth supplied by the assessors for each parcel. The reason listed should be useful and substantiate and justify the new growth listed. The reason must illustrate to the reviewer that the value change to the parcel meets the requirements to be counted as new growth.
The description should also make sense when reviewed in the context of the property, the use code, and the amount of growth. Below are some examples of inadequate and adequate descriptions. Here are some examples of new growth that your reviewer may question. In our first example, the class code listed is a 130. But the reason listed for growth states a new single family home, 4 bedrooms, 3.5 baths. This description alerts the reviewer that the parcel is no longer vacant land. The assessor must correct the use code for this parcel to reflect that due to development, it is now a 101. In the second example, the reason for new growth listed does not pass the reality check for the reviewer. A 12x12 shed is listed as the reason for new growth, but the amount reported for new growth is well beyond what a reviewer would reasonably expect a shed to price out to. The assessor must now go back and correct the typo in the growth amount column. In our third example, the reviewer has flagged the reason for new growth as being unacceptable, as re-roofing the home with the same materials is not considered new growth. Upon further investigation, the assessor found that when the field worker visited the parcel for the roof permit, a barn was discovered that had not been previously assessed. The assessor must correct the reason for new growth to show what actually happened, and not just export the permit data field. In the New Growth Excel template, what is entered as an overall class code in column F must correlate with the appropriate amount of growth column. If what is entered in the overall class code column does not correlate with that class's specific amount of growth column, then the self-filled summary grid will not total correctly. Let's look at some examples. In this first example, the class reported for new growth is a 112, but the amount of new growth was incorrectly entered into column K, which is reserved for the amount of commercial or personal property new growth, instead of the correct column, column I, which is reserved for residential new growth. The result is that the summary grid does not total the new growth correctly. In our second example, we see the same new growth details for the same parcel, only this time, the assessor listed the new growth amount in the correct correlating column, resulting in the new growth being captured and computed to the summary grid.
Now, let's talk a bit about entering mixed-use new growth into the template. Mixed-use new growth entries may reflect growth in only one of the classes, but can also reflect growth in both. It is important that the template entries reflect the growth in all applicable classes correlating to columns I through N so that the LA-13 will calculate the correct amount of new growth to be used in the levy limit calculation, and that in that calculation, the correct property tax rate is being applied. In general, mixed-use new growth should be entered in a single row per parcel with the mixed-use class code listed in column F and the amounts of growth entered in the correlating and applicable columns. Your personal property may be in a different CAMA system from real estate, or may require a different or additional new growth report to be extracted, formatted, and copied into the new growth template. Use column A to enter the account number for each personal property account within the growth report. Use column B to enter the business name of each personal property account. Please ensure that Class 505 and Class 506 new growth reconciles to the DOR new growth. Reviewing and checking growth data. When a parcel has multiple permits or has had multiple inspections, care should be taken to ensure all growth value is captured on a single line and duplication of amounts of growth are avoided. The Bureau of Local Assessment representative who reviews your new growth submission will sort your template by parcel or street address to check for repeated parcels or accounts. Before submission, the assessor should thoroughly review the template for duplicate submissions. Below are some examples of flagged new growth that the assessor must consolidate into a single line for the reviewer.
Let's talk a bit about editing the new growth template. The best practice is to use the same process that you would use to create the LA3 for upload. Make all your edits in a separate spreadsheet before copying into the template. Do not copy the summary grid. Work with columns A through N only. In the separate spreadsheet, you can make all your edits, including inserting rows, deleting rows, and sorting or filtering data with extreme care. In a separate spreadsheet, perform all the required formatting. Then, just as you copy your sales data into the LA3 upload template, you can now copy your growth data into columns A through N in the growth template. A few things that are important to remember in the new growth template. There is no inserting of rows. To add new data, add it at the end of your spreadsheet. There is no deleting rows. Use the backspace key to remove data from each cell. There can be no blank rows in the template, same as the LA3 template. And there is no sorting of data in the new growth template. When it comes to reviewing and checking the growth detail to the summary grid, one way to ensure that all growth is being correctly calculated in the template is to use Excel's status bar sum feature. Do this to reconcile your detail to the summary grid totals. Mismatches indicate that there is a problem with the entered data. First, select the range of cells you want to calculate. To check the total residential growth amount, hold your mouse at the top of column I to select the entire column. In the bottom right of the Excel screen, the status bar will display the average, the count, and the sum. This should equal the total for residential new growth in the summary grid. Do this for each column, I through N, to prove to the respective total in the row of the summary grid. Lastly, check your totals to your expectations, your CAMA extracts, or your historic trends. After the new growth template has been completed, formatted, and reviewed by the assessor, the file must then be uploaded into Gateway. The new growth template must be uploaded to the current documents section of the LA13. Once uploaded, the assessor should ensure that the totals in the summary grid of the new growth template match what has been entered in the LA13 on Gateway. It is important to make sure all assessing staff and field workers are trained to recognize how their work relates to growth. This will vary based on each assessing office's methods of entering permits, data changes, field work, visit history, and various methods of tracking new growth. More information on new growth can be found at the various links listed here. For help and questions on the new growth template, contact your Bureau of Local Assessment field advisor.